Do you want to know something about this man?
What?
He hasn't got any idea at all of what we are going to do to him.
He hasn't. No.
He hasn't, no. He hasn't got any idea at all about any one of the number of things we might do to it.
That we will do to it.
That we will.
Well.
Some of them. We'll do some of them.
Sometimes we do all of them.
Hmm. That can be counterproductive.
Bollocks.
But anyway, here he is. Here he is, sitting here, and he hasn't got the faintest idea of what we might do to him.
He's probably got the faintest idea.
A faint idea, yes, possibly. Have you? Hey? What do you say? Let's just put it this way. He probably has little idea of what we might do to him. Of what, in fact, we are about to do to him.
Or his wife. Don't forget about his wife.
He has little idea of what we're about to do to her.
No. He probably has some idea. He probably has some idea. After all, he's read the papers.
What papers?
Well, you're right there.
Who is this cunt, anyway? What is he, some sort of fucking peasant or a lecturer in theology?
He's a lecturer in fucking peasant theology.
Is he? What about his wife?
Well, women don't have theological inclinations.
Oh, I don't know. I used to discuss that question with my mother. Quite often.
What question?
Well, the theological aspirations of the female.
Yes? What did she say?
She said, I can't remember. Motherfucker!
Fuck pig!
You know what I find really disappointing?
What?
It's the level of ignorance that surrounds us. I mean, take this prick here.
You called him a cunt before. Last time.
What?
You called him a cunt last time. Now you call him a prick? How many times have I got to tell you the terms? You have to learn to define your terms and stick to them. You can't call him a cunt in one breath and a prick with the next. The terms are mutually contradictory. You'd lose face in any linguistics discussion group. Take my tip.
Christ, would I?
Yes, definitely. And you know what it means to you. You know what language means to you.
Yes, I do know.
Yes, you do know. Look at this man here, for example. He's a first-class example. Before he came in here, he was a big shot. Never stopped shooting off at the mouth. Never stopped questioning received ideas. Now. Because he's apprehensive about what's going to happen to him. He stopped all that. He's pretty much called it a day. Once, not too long ago. This was a man of conviction, wasn't he? Man of principle. Now he's just a prick.
Or a cunt.
We haven't even finished with him yet. We haven't even begun.
No. We haven't even finished with him. Well, we haven't even begun.
And there's still his wife to come.
That's right. We haven't even finished with him. We haven't even begun. We
haven't finished with his wife either.
We haven't even begun.
What are you crying about?
I love it. I love it. I love it!
Listen, I have to tell you. I've got to tell you. There's no one else I can tell.
All right, fine. Go on, then. Tell me.
I feel so pure.
Well, you're right. You're right. To feel pure. Do you know why?
Why?
Because you're keeping the world clean for democracy. I'm going to shake you by the hand. Yes. And so will he. In about, 35 minutes.
Not to love the Fuhrer is a great disgrace, so be heil!